hospital in Jeddah. He will talk about obstacles and endoscopic discectomy.
Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. Thank you for invitation. I think it is difficult now after the prof to put my presentation, but I will do it inshallah. I will talk about an obstacle in the full endoscopic discectomy. I'll talk about full endoscopic through interlaminar for L5S1 disc and why so specific about this point. I'm using uniportal, not biportal like the prof. It is a uniportal, as you can see in the picture. Contain the camera, the sleeve, the working channel, the instrument. The working sleeve is diameter about 7 millimeter, and all instrument is less than this, between 2.5 and 2, okay? So why about L5S1? My mentor always teach me to do it L5S1. Do it L5S1 until you master it. So I did some research, I read. There is a lot of anatomical variation in this area. First, as we can see in the red line, smallest laminar overhang of the lumbar level of L5 by comparing to other level. Second thing, by black, larger interlaminar space. By yellow, inferior margin of the upper lamina lie at the level relatively posterior to the superior margin of the lower lamina, which make different in plane, that make the plane is wide and larger. Then we can see by the blue line, trapezoidal configuration that allow more working space for the outer cannula and its manipulation during procedure. So we have also from facet to facet, give wide interlaminar space 21 to 40 millimeter, not like other levels. And the nerve root is horizontal takeoff. Okay? This picture is very nice. We can see the relation and see the difference between L4, L5, and L5S1 and the working channel. All this anatomical information, when we apply it to the X-ray, we can find this X-ray, for example, your patient will not be become like the picture in the book. Like this patient, he has already abnormal sacralization of the level. But if we apply our working area, we can see the interlaminar space in the L4, L5 is smaller, and L5, S1 is wider and bigger. There is a relative contraindication, mashallah, prof, yani, destroy all this. Severe decrease in disc high, he can do TLIF, severe facet hypertrophy, nerve root anomaly, calcified disc, or caudic vaina. For uniportal, I'm not doing for caudic vaina patient. So what is endoscopic surgery? It is target-oriented surgery, not full visualization of bone, nor the relation of neural structure by preoperative radiograph, and know the appearance of the structure in the endoscopy. If we find fat globule, that means it is epidural fat. If we find pink accompanied with blood supply, mostly nerve. If it is fluffy white, it is a disc. And if there is pulsating structure, this is the dura. This is picture, we can see. Ligamentum flavum by yellow, dura and herniated nucleus pulposus and epidural fat. Our routine endoscopic procedure is identify the level, insert the scope, identify the ligamentum flavum, incise it, protect the neural structure, and fragmentectomy. This is the main surgery, fragmentectomy. This is the wound. So this is the ligamentum flavum. We target the ligamentum flavum in pinpoint and cut it until we found the space. From the space, we go from medial to lateral to incise the ligamentum flavum. See now, we can see there is a hole, and from the hole, I'll bring the scissor from medial to lateral until make my channel and go through it. Okay. Then, directly after identify, go through the ligamentum flavum, identify the nerve. Here, this is, I can show you. When I retract the nerve, I retract the nerve. The nerve in the at 12 o'clock is the medial side. So I retract it medially and rotate the sleeve to find the annular tear. See, here's the annular tear, and the part of the herniated disc is, as you can see. So our main obstacle we'll talk about today is if it is associated with canal stenosis and how to extract axillary herniated disc, shoulder herniated disc, migrated disc, huge sequestrated disc, and the discectomy in extreme obese patient. So simply, if the patient has ligamentum flavum hypertrophied or facet hypertrophy, it is not our standard, but in this cases we should do ligamentum flavum resection and partial facetectomy. And the axillary disc, this is our fun part in the endoscopy. It is the easiest one. Why? Because the S1, as we talk about anatomy, displaced the S1 nerve root far into the subarticular region, creating potential space between the thecal sac and the nerve root. Okay? Approach between S1 nerve root and dura, quick learning curve, have a good impression, advantage, useful for downgrade migrated herniated nucleus pulposus. Okay? The other part is herniation at the level of the axillary, of the shoulder. Uncommon in these cases, in L5, S1, in this case, the herniated disc pushed the S1 nerve root medially toward the thecal sac. So it will obliterate the working space, and the disc become lateral and behind all the structure, nerve root and the dura. So we should do, this is a picture for discectomy. Dr. Professor White asked, approach between lamina and shoulder area of S1 nerve root, pushed nerve root posterior and medial toward the dura. Neuromonitor, because I'm doing it general anesthesia, I'm not using neuromonitor, I'm using my assistant. I ask my assistant, put your hand on the patient's feet. If you feel by electricity, you can find some movement, yeah, yes, this is the nerve. Okay, so I will do partial facetectomy. So we can go lateral and push the nerve and reach the disc. Okay, this is how we do facetectomy. See? We can see if I did not do facetectomy, all this bone is covering the root. Still, I need to go in front of the root to bring the disc. Okay, so I must do facetectomy. We can see the bone here. I'm doing it very minimal. So I'm using the Carrison here to just make some sort of facetectomy. And now we, after facetectomy, partial, I have working space. I can go lateral to this nerve root and go to reach the disc. Migrated disc. This is yani, our conflict in the meeting. Usually they said you cannot reach the far migrated up or downward disc, but we can change by simple change in the insertion of the working sleeve and channel. If the disc is migrated upward, make your insert a little bit down, not directly like we said before, two centimeter and go down. No, make it down a little bit to grasp it from the upside. If the disc is migrated downward, make your insert two millimeter upward and to grasp it from downward. This is this picture. Usually, I took it from bipartal picture, but it gave us hint. But in bipartal picture, they can do it in multi-level on the same insertion. Okay, and this is bipolar. We can see it reach far upward. Huge disc. A lot of my colleague ask me if the working sleeve is 7 millimeter. How you extract huge disc? It is simple. You should reach the disc and grasp it and remove it with the camera and keep the sleeve inside in place. Here is the only time I need the assistant. You can see my hand there and my assistant remove the camera with the disc, with the punch, all together, but keep the sleeve inside. So we can extract even large disc like we see 4 or 5 centimeters, and this huge. This I learned by my mentor yesterday. I have an extreme obese patient. I use the inferior one, inferior scope for the interlaminar, but the patient was really, really obese. So it was very difficult. It was very difficult for me to manipulate it, but he told me, you can use the other one. The other one is used for transforaminal. If the patient very obese, you can use the transforaminal. You can reach directly and without any difficulty. Take home message. Preoperative X-ray and landmark identify disc space, MRI, side and site, and migration must be studied well before the surgery. Entry point is a great help, and never hesitate to convert to open at any time. Okay, thank you very much.
Any questions? Dr. Muhammad, receive any questions?